everyone. Today I thought I would take advantage of the little bit of springtime that we have left and do a springtime inspired smoky eye and hair tutorial. So this is the makeup that we're doing today. And this is the hair. As you can see, it's a little rose inspired by flowers for spring. And I actually put some leaves in there as well, just to add kind of a natural little bohemian edge to it. So this is all very easy. I know it looks complicated, like a lot goes into it, but it probably altogether took me like 10 minutes. I have been doing something a little different with my eye makeup the past couple weeks, a little taboo, and I'm actually really starting to enjoy it. And what that is brush-free eye makeup. So I pretty much apply my eye makeup with my fingers. I did this with my fingertips. I like the feeling of, you know, actually touching it and blending it myself. And it might be the crazy artist in me that just likes to be really tactile with my materials and my mediums, but it comes out great. I mean, the only thing that I really used a brush for was to define my brows because the pads of my fingers are a little too thick. But I'm gonna do the tutorial with you guys today brush free as well with my fingers because I want you to see exactly how I did this, and who knows, maybe it'll catch on for you too. So let's get started. We're gonna start with hair and we're gonna move on to makeup. So make your part however you want it. Just make sure that you can take a little section of hair immediately to one side of your part, whatever side you're going to do your flower on. And the first thing that you're going to do, divide it into two and just twist it in the opposite direction of your head. Just twisting. And you're gonna pin it back here. You can do it straight across, you can do it as high or as low as you want. I like it to have a little bit of like droop in it like that. So you just take a pin and kind of like hide it in there. Just like that, okay? Now, to start with your flower, you're gonna take a section of hair immediately next to your twist, like, say like that. Again, it does not need to be perfect. Just make sure you don't take all of the hair like this. Make sure you leave a little bit hanging down under it. You're gonna use this little section here to make the other part of like your wraparound. And what you're gonna do is take this section here and make it into a nice tight braid. Now take your finger here and just start to wrap your braid around. So you have like, I'm trying to show you, like a little loop. Just keep wrapping it around the loop so it lays flat and it gets wider and wider. So you end up like that. So once you have it like that, just hide your bobby pins in the back and secure it down. See that? Now, take that little section that I told you to leave out, twist it. Bring it to the other side, to the back. Again, you can do it high up, you can do it low, but I'm going to drop it low. Drop it low. Like that. I got these leaves off a little garland of flowers from the 99-cent store, and when you pull them off, they have this little hole in the middle that is perfect to stick a bobby pin through. So I just place it kind of strategically wherever it looks the most natural, right behind it. And that's it. There's your springtime rose, and let's get started on our spring smoky eye. Alright, so I've taken the makeup off of this side of my face. I started with the MAC Face and Body Foundation. I just applied a pea-sized amount to my fingertip and just really lightly did it over my face. Also, I used it as a primer because I'm out of my primer. So this worked fine. It is good to have a little bit of wetness on your lid, so when you use your fingers, you know, you can blend more easily. The first thing that I did was take an eyeliner. This is a pencil by L'Oreal Bare Natural in Onyx. It's a mineral eyeliner. And I just did a kind of a imprecise line across the bottom of my lid. And this is all going to be blended out, so it's kind of supposed to start off looking messy. After I did this, I took a navy blue. So just take any navy blue eyeshadow, and I'm using my pointer finger to pick up the color, and I'm just patting it on top of that black So just pat it on here. Okay, and then you can blend out once you've gotten your color on just a little bit so that it starts to go up into your crease. Now, the next thing that I did was I took this light blue. And here's one bit of advice when you use your fingers. The most important thing is cleaning your fingers in between colors. So I have a little towel here. Don't get your fingers wet, or if you do, just make sure they're very dry before you change your next color, because you don't want it to look all muddy. So take your light blue on your finger and just dab it about from your crease down to halfway over your lid so it blends into that dark blue. Just pat. And with my finger, I'm able to get a lot of control and also less fallout for some reason than with a brush. Next, I'm taking my e.l.f. Brightening Eye Pot. This is a lilac color. I know it's hard to see with my lighting in my bathroom what colors I'm using. And I'm doing this up in my crease and again blending it down into the darker colors. For under my brow, I took this e.l.f. Liquid Eyeshadow. It's a champagne color, like a goldy sort of, but not exactly gold, it's champagne. And I just went under my brow here, and I blended it out. See, it has like that nice sheen to it. Now I take my eyeliner again, and I just kind of go back over my lash line and in my waterline. Then I also go under my lash line. Now for my brows, I find that using a brow pencil makes my eyes look too like harsh. It makes my brows look like they're painted on. So I just take a dark brown eyeshadow and put it on a brush with a thin angled tip, and I just sort of fill in my brow to give it a little bit of definition. For my mascara, I'm using the Great Lash Blackest Black mascara. And I do usually curl my lashes first, but for time's sake, I'm not going to right now. And just apply two coats of this. On my face, I used a bronzer. This is the Estee Lauder Bronze Goddess Soft Matte Bronzer. And I just pick it up on my brush, tap off the excess, go up to create a contour of your cheek. For lips, I did a very soft pink. This is a CoverGirl Nude Shine lipstick. It's number 470. And it comes off just nude and like a touch of pink. So I did this. I didn't use any liner because, again, I want it to look kind of natural and soft. And then I topped it with this Jordana Squeeze and Shine lip gloss in Pink Punk, and it's just a very like creamy, very very light pink. And that's the lip. So this is the look. I hope you guys like it. If you have any suggestions for next time, please let me know. Write me a comment, send me a message, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so already. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye. Baby, I can